Welcome to The Business Coach, a show in which you're out to help entrepreneurs better their business. My name is Ian Dennis, and today on this show, we'll be exploring the tech business. I'll be linking up with a gentleman named Abraham, who runs UserPoint, and I'll find out what exactly are some of the challenges he's facing in his tech business. And later on this show, I'll be linking him up to Hilda Mora, one of the few Kenyans who have started and actually sold their companies for millions of dollars. Keep it right here on The Business Coach. All right, so Abraham, welcome to the show.
Okay, thank you very much for having me.
So I'd like to start by saying congratulations. You won the Total Startup Challenge. Tell me, what exactly was it about?
The Total Startup Challenge is a challenge by Total. They do it every year. Last year, 2018, they were doing it in 59 countries. Previously, it was about 30-something. So they're trying to find solutions in the market which are budding and are solving problems in the society. So we came from an application list of about 807 applicants, shortlisted to 15 finalists, and finally I managed to get the second runners up with a prize of 1 million.
A million shillings.
Yes.
So what does UserPoint do? That's a company that you run.
Yes.
What exactly do you guys do?
So UserPoint is derived from two words, user and point. User means selling, point means place. So when you combine the two, it simply means a point of sale. Packaged as an enterprise resource planning for the small scale businesses, so small and medium sized businesses. So currently we've been focusing mostly on the medium sized kind of businesses, but right now we've seen the growing need of going to the very small scale, the informal sector, which constitutes about 90% of the market in Kenya. And so we are trying to offer them a solution that will be able to automate their business operations.
So break it down to me, because you know it's technical stuff. So break it down to me. What solution do you offer to your clients?
So it's a mobile application for small businesses. Medium-sized businesses can access it over the web. So if you have the mobile application, you just download, install, and use it on a day-to-day basis to keep track of your stock.
Mm-hmm. So the client primarily is a retailer?
Yes, the client primarily is a retailer. So when you're receiving stock, you put it on the system. When you're selling to customers, you keep it on your system. When you're trying to send purchase orders to suppliers, you use the same platform. And also we are trying to upgrade it to a level where also customers, when you're seated at home, you can order unga from your nearest Duka or kiosk.
Using
that particular application. If you look at these kind of businesses, they just depend on walk-in customers. So what if we take it a level higher and we allow these particular Duka owners to have access to kind of an e-commerce service where you're just on your consumer app and you can order directly to that Duka.
Also, in a nutshell, sort of like you've digitized the
retail chain completely. Yes, so it's actually more of a complete revolution for the retail space in Africa.
You mentioned to me that cash flow has been a challenge in the business.
Yes.
So tell me more about it. What has been causing that to make it a challenge?
Yes, so for us, when we started off, it was mostly, I call them client-based solutions, where we used to go to customers and install software to them. And that's not a sustainable kind of business.
So the software is just the UserPoint software?
Yeah, UserPoint software. You just go
the
and
the point
install,
of sale.
Yes, the point of sale. So you go and install it to a customer and they pay you a one-off, and the next time they're paying you is the license fee the beginning of the next year. So you'll find that kind of model is not very, very sustainable. So right now we've built a software as a service kind of model where you can go onto our website, sign up yourself, access the system from there, and just pay a subscription every month. However, some of the major challenges we've gotten from our cash flow is one, having the wrong model of interacting with customers, as I've mentioned. The second thing has been very high cost.
Customer development. Most entrepreneurs, while building their product, forget about the client, who is the end user of the product. The customer development process seeks to challenge the entrepreneurial mindset by having the entrepreneur have a grasp of who the client is while building their product. The process is driven by a hypothesis approach to understand who the customer is, what needs they have, their behavior, and how to best monetize the product. The customer development process works in parallel with the product development and entails four phases. Customer discovery. Here is where you seek to understand who your most valuable client is and whom you can create a business model around. Customer validation. Here is where you seek to understand who your most valuable client is and with whom you can create a business model around. customer creation, once you unmask your most valuable client, here you start to create a scalable model. Company building, this is the final phase where you can scale your organizations and operation as your business serves your most valuable clients.
And as it is right now, you'd mentioned to me that the only solution that you guys are selling is just the OZA point of sale.
Yes.
But you also mentioned to me about now how you're trying now to scale up the business. Tell me more about it.
Okay, so as I've mentioned, we are trying to change the model. Instead of just going to customers and installing for them our solution, customers, we're trying to do a lot of digital advertising so that we make sure customers can just land on our website and be able to get the platform online. We pay for the cloud services and everything. The only thing they focus on is the putting their products in and doing all that. So we hope with that the approach will be much better. Also for the small scale kind of business, we are looking for agents who can resell our products to these people, who can have a last
to
the retailers, who can have a loyal kind of relationship, and we can give them also a commission out of every revenue we make from them. And so we'll be doing very many advertisements to call for people who want to resell our products, and we have a good reseller agreement with them.
And you'd mentioned to me, like, capital has been one of the biggest challenges the business is facing, because you guys always, probably you told me that sometimes you're operating on fumes. Mm-hmm. But you'd mentioned to me at a point whereby you got an investor to come on board. Tell me about, what's it called, the investment, how exactly it came about, and also how exactly you guys spread your investment.
Okay, so I am a beneficiary of a foundation. It's called the Mbogo and Rosemary Foundation. And when they had a pitch session, One of the people in the crowd decided, I think I like that business. It's a very nice dream. I want to invest in it. So they gave us at least 1 million Kenya shillings to get the product in development and research and all that. However, it's only a significant amount of money that can run you quite some amount of time. We focus a lot, most of our investment, mostly on product development and research, because that is our intellectual property, that is our biggest kind of investment, because people are buying into our product, into our solution.
MVP, Minimal Viable Product. MVP is a concept from Lean Startup by Eric Ries that stresses on developing a product with minimal features to satisfy early adopters, who are the people willing to purchase your product in its early phase. The methodology is on a feedback loop, which entails build, measure, and learn. The emphasis is to quickly build a product with minimal features that most clients will use. Give it to a select number of people to use, then measure their feedback. You will go through the loop several times to get the best possible product for the market. MVP allows you to quickly create and scale a product that the market needs.
So you've won so many accolades. When someone Googles Abraham Mbuthia, so many accolades come into context. Tell me about the awards you've won and what impact has those awards had in your entrepreneurial journey?
Okay, so in 2017, I won the Techpreneur of the Year and the Founder of the Year awards, which is done by Founder Magazine. In 2017 as well, I won the Top 40 Under 40 Men in Kenya by the Business Daily. In 2018, I was listed amongst the 100 most influential Kenyans under the science and technology category. And most recently, I was the runners-up in the Total Startup Challenge in Kenya and got a cash prize of 1 million Kenya shillings.
And finally, as a business, what are some of the aspirations that you guys do hold, and where exactly do you wish to take your business in the next couple of years?
For us, our values are mostly focused on creating an impact in society. We do not develop any solutions that we don't believe have a genuine impact. And I believe even from the accolades, that's why we get some recognition, because the products that we are developing are very impactful to the society. And so for us, we are looking at a point where we become a household name because of offering a genuine solution, not just in Kenya, but also in Africa. If I look at my company, I would want it to be like the Google of Africa. And we want to change the narrative and the conversation in Kenya. We want to see great innovations growing from here and being spoken about all over in the world. And that's
so
where
it's going international.
Yes, it's going international. And that's where I want to take the business.
So after the break, I'll be linking up Abraham to Hilda Morau, one of the entrepreneurs who's just been beyond words. She's started, grown, and scaled her business, and she exited with over 100 million Kenya shillings. So keep it right here on The Business Coach, where we help entrepreneurs better their business.